Hello guys and welcome to AVK App Reviews. Today I am gonna give you the overview for Dirty Unicorn ROM for Nexus 5. This ROM is based on AOSP. So let's check it out. Firstly, I am gonna show you the Android version provided by this ROM. This ROM provides Android version 5.0.2. I am running the latest build, that is version 9.0 of Dirty Unicorn ROM. Now this build is released on Jan 17, 2015. I'm running the stock kernel that come along with this ROM, that is Unicorn Blood kernel. Let's check out the customization provided by this ROM. Now the customization can be seen under a tab called Dirty Tweaks. Now as you can see, they have provided different UI, that is tabbed UI. You have to scroll through different tab to access different customization. So it's a good UI. I'm loving this UI. Now, the first tab is General UI. Inside that there are two options, misc tweak and LCD density. Inside misc tweak, you can disable the immersive mode message, you can enable the brightness control over status bar, and you can also enable the double to sleep feature over status bar. Then next is LCD density. You can vary the LCD density of screen if you want. Then next tab is status bar. There are four options: traffic indicator, clock and date, battery option and quick settings. Inside traffic indicator, you can enable the traffic monitor on status bar. As you can see, I have enabled it. Then you can change the color of that monitor. Then you can change the display unit, that is beats per second or bytes per second. Then you can change the update interval. And you can also auto hide the monitor if the network is not in use. Then next customization is clock and date. You can enable the clock or disable it. Then you can change the color of the clock. Then you can change the alignment to right or center, as you can see. Then you can enable the AM/PM indicator. Then you can also enable the date, and you can choose the date format from this option. Then next option is battery options. You can change the battery icon to circle, icon portrait, icon landscape, text or hidden. Then you can enable the battery percentage inside the icon, next to icon, or keep it hidden. Then next is you can enable the battery bar, that is above status bar or top of navbar or bottom of the navbar. Then you can enable the charging animation over the battery bar. Then you can change the color of the battery bar, and you can also vary the thickness of the battery bar. Then next option is the quick setting. Inside that you can enable or disable the brightness slider. As you can see, currently my brightness slider is enabled, so you can make it disabled. So now it's gone. Then next is you can change the order of the tiles. As you can see, currently my Wi-Fi is located on the third row, so just hold it and drag it where you want. So now my Wi-Fi is the first icon. So as you can see, my Wi-Fi is in first row. Then next option is you can enlarge or dislarge the first row. Then you can enable the quick pull down from right side or left hand side of the status bar. Then next tab is the navigation bar. Currently there is no customization available for navigation bar, but it will be available in the next build. Then next is multitasking. There are three options: Omni switch, Gesture Anywhere, and App Circle Bar. If you enable the Omni switch, you will see there is a glowing dot on the right hand side of screen. Just click on the dot, you will open this menu. Then you can clear all your recent menu. Then you can go back to your home page, and you can also also open your app drawer here. So it's a good feature. Then next is Gesture Anywhere. You can choose a specific gesture for opening or closing of any app. By enabling this, you will see there is a window on right hand side. You have to draw a specific gesture on the window, and it will open the assigned app. You can change the width, position and the height of this bar, and you can also change the location of this bar, that is left edge and right edge. Then next is App Circle Bar. By enabling it, you can see there is a scrolling app menu. You can change the app inside this scrolling app menu, and you can also vary the width, position and height of this app menu. The next tab is a system. Inside that you can change the power menu setting. As you can see, you can enable or disable the tab inside this power, inside the power menu. So whichever tab you want to choose, you can select this, and you can also enable the advanced reboot menu or make it disable. Then next is recents. You can disable the search bar in recent. Currently it is enabled, but you can make it disable. Then you can enable the clear all button in recent, and you can choose the position of the button. Then next is ad blocker. You can enable the ad blocker so it will block all the ads. Then next option is buttons. You can enable the volume as your wake up button, means it will wake up your device whenever you press the volume button. Then next tab is miscellaneous. Here you can download the bank's gapp or a regular gapp. So it's a good option to have. It will directly download the gapps for you. Now the another customization can be seen on a tab called display, where you can enable or disable the ambient display, and you can also change the timeout of the ambient display, and you can also enable the wake up on charge setting. Now let's talk about battery life. Now battery life of this ROM is pretty good. I am impressed with the battery life. This ROM provides you a battery life of a whole day with a screen time of 4 hour and above. So it's a good ROM in terms of battery life. Now another feature of this ROM is, this ROM provides you the option of flashing a blacked gapps. Means it will give you the full black gapps. As you can see, my Play Store is full black and in transparent black. So it looks pretty good. Also my YouTube app is also blacked. So it looks great. Also my Hangouts app is also turned into black theme. So the link for the black gapp is provided in this ROM page. I will be giving the link in my description also. So I will recommend this ROM for you. Thank you for watching my video. Subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos, and follow me on Google+, Facebook and my blog. Thank you.